Hi guys, some of you guys have asked me to make a video about the bump I was making in the side window to prevent the feather to having too much contact on the shelf. And today we are going to try to make that video, and we are going to use this bow. And on this bow we can see that we have the exact same problem that we are talking about. With the feather is tearing up the rest material in the side window, okay? And this bow is the Cascade Brushhawk, and this bow is 40 pounds at 28 inches, and it's a nice shooter, and it's a pretty nice bow too, as you can see. It's only 56 inches long, so it's a good bow for tree stands and blinds and so. I'm using some different stuff to make this bump with, and one of the things I'm using is what I'm gonna call a flower stick, one of these sticks we are using to hold the flowers when they are little, okay? And then I'm going to use some Velcro, and I have a black marker and scissors, and I have this tape with the double adhesives on both sides, okay? As you can see, I have this rest or this spare of the Velcro with the where I already have this tape glued on, so I'm gonna, as you can see, it's when I'm making the strike plates, as you can see, okay? So I'm just gonna take a slice of this. And I don't need this to be bigger than the arrow. So if the arrow is, as you can see, the width of the arrow have to match the Velcro for the strike plates. And as you can see, I need to cut a little bit off over here. This. Okay. And then I'm gonna take this flower stick, and I'm gonna take my knife, and then I'm gonna cut this flower stick. I'm gonna cut this about here, and again this need to be the same width as the arrow, okay? Like this. And the next I'm gonna do is actually to split this small piece of wood. I'm gonna split this in half with the knife. And then I'm not gonna split it exactly in the middle. I'm gonna split it, I don't know what you call this in English, but as you can see, if we are gonna make it closer. As you can see, it's split like this. Okay. So, and the one I'm gonna use is this one. And then I'm taking another piece of this this tape, and I'm gonna put this small piece of flower stick on this tape, and I'm gonna cut the tape like this. Okay, so now I have this small piece of wood with the tape on it. I'm gonna lay it there. And then we're gonna remove the old rest material from this bow. We are scraping the old glue off as good as we can, like that. So now I'm gonna put this bump on this bow. And I'm gonna put it as close to the to where I have my hand. This groove right here. I don't know what it's called, but this is where I'm having my hand, as close to that as possible. Okay. And the reason why I'm gonna stick this tight with this tape, this bump, it's because I don't want it to move. So now we are taking the shelf material. And I'm gonna put this on top of this. Like this. Okay. And the black marker is actually just for making this black, this piece of wood. So here you have it, the bump on the bow. And these flower sticks, you can just put them back in the flowers. Back in the days, this stick was about this long. But if you're just taking a little piece at a time, your wife will never know. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.